I think when you want to make a propaganda of your own work, you have to repeat and repeat the same image all the time at different places in the city. And the stencil is a very good medium for that, because you do it very fast. It takes you 30 seconds to make one stencil, and you can repeat it million times, thousand times in the same city. So the people can see in the first time they say, "Oh, what is this?" Second time, they say, "Oh, again." And so after that, the people they ask, "Who is the guy?" It's happened to me like that, and the people in Paris ask, "Who is the guy who makes those rides in Paris?" And I started to be known in this way. Everything started for me in Italy in the early 60s, when I made a trip to Padova with my parents, and I saw the vestige of the World War II propaganda made by the fascists. I saw, at that time I was 10 years old, early 60s, 61, and I saw on the wall of Padova the portrait of Mussolini made by stencil, and Mussolini with an helmet and profile like that, and the fascist was making the propaganda like that. And I asked to my father, what does it mean, you know, why people are doing this? And my father explained to me that it was done during the World War II, and the fascists was making propaganda for the party all over Italy with stencil. And they used roller, they used to make stencil on metal, and they use a roller and they make propaganda like that. And so I keep this in my mind for a long time, for 40 years, and for 20 years. And when I tried to make an American graffiti, but I didn't have the skill. So I remember to have seen this when I was a young guy. And so I decided to make stencil for this reason. For me, it's the same thing, you know. I don't see any difference. And even the first graffiti in the cavern, you know, in the caves, when the people start to put their hand on the wall of the caves, it was exactly the same strategy than now, because I think they wanted to leave their trace, you know, somewhere.